In last video, we had seen the details about inductive effect. And if you have any doubt regarding inductive effect, you may visit my last video. Now in this video, we will see some of the important application of inductive effect. Inductive effect is considered as a very important or vital electronic effect in organic chemistry, as it helps in understanding or explaining various important phenomena in organic chemistry. It has a wide application, such as it explains the effect on bond length due to the inductive effect. It also helps in determining the acidic strength of any acid. Thirdly, it also explains the stability of reactive intermediate. Reactive intermediates such as carbocation, carbidine, free radical. Fourthly, it also helps in determining the basicity of amines. And it also helps in understanding the reactivity of alkyl halides. But in this video, we will be more focusing on first two application, that is effect on bond length and the acidity of acid. First, that is effect on bond length. As inductive effect leads to the ionic character in the bond. For example, over here in alkyl halide. So fluorine has the electronegativity of 4.0. Carbon has the electronegativity of 2.5. So fluorine is more electronegative and it also shows minus I effect. Due to the minus I effect of the fluorine, it will gain delta negative charge and carbon will gain a delta positive charge. So inductive effect imparts ionic character in the bond. This is the simple relationship between inductive effect, bond length and bond strength. As minus I effect of any group increases, bond length gets reduced and bond strength will increase. So over here, in all this alkyl halide, all this halogen shows minus I effect. So among this halogen, fluorine has the highest minus I effect, then chlorine, then bromine, and then iodine. Here, the bond length of methyl fluoride is about 1.38 angstrom. In methyl chloride, here the bond length is 1.78 angstrom. And in methyl bromide, the bond length is about 1.94 angstrom, and in methyl iodide 2.14 angstrom. So in methyl fluoride, this fluorine has the highest minus I effect. So minus I effect is highest, so bond length is very small. And as bond length is very small, this bond is stronger bond. So it requires higher energy to break this bond. And in case of methyl chloride, minus I effect of chlorine is somewhat lesser than fluorine. So its bond length is 1.78. So it requires lesser energy to break this bond. In case of methyl bromide, it also needs more lesser energy compared to methyl fluoride and methyl chloride. And in case of methyl iodide, this iodine has the least minus I effect among the halogen. So bond length is very high. So bond strength is very weak. So very less energy is required to break this bond. So this is the overall effect of inductive effect on bond length and bond strength. So now the second application is determining the acidity of acid. As minus I effect increases, the conjugate base or anions which are formed after losing of proton from the acid, that is the more stable this conjugate base is, more stronger is the acid. For example, over here, consider HA is any acid. Acid means it will donate H+. plus it will form anion. And this anion, it is also called as a conjugate base. So more stable is conjugate bases, more stronger is the acid. In organic chemistry, you must remember negative charge is stabilized by negative effect. It is negative minus I effect or minus M effect. Positive charge is stabilized by positive I or plus M effect. So over here, we will see all this in a proper way by solving some of the examples. Over here, all these examples are of alcohol. So here, alcohol is considered as a weak acid. So it will donate H plus ion. And it will form a conjugate base as negative charge is on oxygen. Now, as we already know, negative charge is stabilized by minus M or minus I effect. But this 3-methyl group shows plus I effect. So here there is a 3 plus I effect because of 3-methyl group. So it will destabilize this conjugate base. Here 2 plus I effect destabilizing this conjugate base. And over here, ethyl group destabilizing this conjugate base. And here only 1 plus I effect destabilizing this conjugate base. So in 4, only 1 plus I effect which makes the conjugate base less stable. So 4 is more stronger acid than 3, than 2, than 1. So next example is, so whenever you are comparing the acidity of any acid, first you must form the conjugate base. As all the examples given are acid, so they will donate H plus ion and they will form a conjugate base, that is anion. And in organic chemistry, you must remember this negative charge is stabilized by minus I or minus M effect. And this is stabilized, and it also gets destabilized by plus I or plus M effect. And in first example, or in first compound, I must say, this CH2 is bonded to fluorine and it is halogen. So here also you must remember, whenever this CH2 is bonded to any halogen, that is fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, it will show minus I effect. And here, fluorine is more electronegative. That is, fluorine has the highest minus I effect among the halogen. So it will stabilize this conjugate base more effectively. While in second compound, CH2 is also bonded to halogen, that is bromine. But bromine shows a lesser minus I effect compared to fluorine. So it will stabilize this conjugate base to a lesser extent than the fluorine. And in third compound, this methyl shows plus I effect. It totally destabilizes this conjugate base or anion. So the right order of acidity is 1 is more acidic than 2, than 3. So next example. So first you have to make the conjugate base. As all the compounds given are acid, so they will donate H plus and they form a conjugate base. As conjugate base is negatively charged, so it will stabilize by negative effect. And we already know, whenever CH2 group is attached to any halogen, it will show minus I effect. So fluorine among the halogen, if you have any idea about the minus I series, among the halogen, fluorine has the highest minus I effect, then chlorine, then bromine, and then iodine. So first compound, that is CH2F, has the or show the highest minus I effect. So it will highly stabilize this conjugate base. Then chlorine will stabilize, then bromine, and then iodine. So the correct option is 1, 3, 2, and 4. So these are the acidic strength order. So the next example. So first, both the compound given are acid, so it will donate H plus ion, and there will be a formation of conjugate base. So in first compound, hydrogen do not show any type of inductive effect, so the conjugate base remains as it is. While in second compound, this methyl shows plus I effect. So plus I effect destabilizes this negative charge. So first, that is a formic acid, is more stronger acid than acetic acid. So I hope you understand the application of inductive effect for bond strength and bond length, and also for determining the acidity of acid. So the remaining application of inductive effect will be seen in next video. Thank you.